What would be more general is to have the transparent filter's color affect the color behind it. In other words, we want to blend the two colors. In blending in computer graphics, the original color is called the destination, and the color of the transparent object we're looking through is called the source color. We'd also like to control how much can be seen through this filter. In computer graphics, this control value is called alpha. Here it represents our filter's opacity. When alpha is 1, the filter is fully opaque and does not let any light through. As this value decreases, more of the destination color becomes visible. Here I'm just showing how the red is affected. The blue would show through. When alpha is 0, our filter is entirely transparent and has no effect. A typical way to blend these colors is by using this equation. Here the color of the source of our filter is multiplied by the source's alpha. This gives how much the source will affect the final color. The larger alpha is, the more the source color affects the final color. To counterbalance this, this same alpha is subtracted from 1, and this value determines how much the destination color influences the result. This type of blend is called an over operator, as it gives the effect of putting one color over another. The alpha of the source, our transparent filter, can be any value from 0 to 1. If the value is 0, this equation simply becomes C is equal to the destination color, since the source filter is entirely transparent. If the value of alpha is 1, the source is fully opaque and hides whatever it's being placed over. The equation simplifies as expected, with the final color being the same as the source color. The alpha value blends between these two colors. Another way to say it is that the equation performs linear interpolation. As one color's influence increases, the other color's effect drops off in proportion. This idea of having a control value, in this case alpha, that varies between 0 and 1, is commonly used in many areas of computer graphics. Expect to see this sort of equation elsewhere as you explore the field. The over operator is useful for transparency. However, there are many other blend modes available in WebGL. For example, one blend mode is called add, as it adds the source and destination colors together. In 3JS, the blend mode used is specified with the material's blending parameter. Here we see the over equation in action. By varying the alpha, we fade the effect of the transparent object on and off. Try it yourself.